An ER doctor and mom reviews the LifeVac and the Dechoker. I tried them both and I looked at all the data. Do they work? There is no head-to-head comparison between either of these and standard choking therapies like the Heimlich abdominal thrust and back blows in living humans. The manufacturer's data looks great, but it's in mannequins and they didn't compare it with anything. The rest of the studies are few and mixed. Some show some possible benefit to the LifeVac, but it is not definitive, and none of them have the same results as the manufacturers. The problem is, these aren't harmless. They can cause throat swelling and bleeding, making it harder to get the object out. And what scares me most is that you have to get a really good seal around the mouth for these to be effective. That is tough. One study found that over 40% of parents couldn't do this. I couldn't get them to work every time. When that happens, they are useless and you are wasting precious seconds. That's why no major medical association advocates using these. So these aren't the first thing I'd reach for. Here's how I would handle choking. Number one is start with really good standard choking therapy and Heimlich and back blows. Most people don't do these correctly. Pro tip, most parents don't do a hard enough back blow, so make sure you know how to do this. Number two, if you do want to buy one of these devices in case it might create some marginal benefit, I'd only use them if 2 to 3 rounds of standard choking care don't work, if you have practiced using them, and if using one of these doesn't delay care. If so, I'd give it a good 1 to 2 tries, then resume standard care. For my demo and more details on all of this, check out my full video series. Comment choking below, and I will make sure that you do not miss it.